Hello and good afternoon. My name is Mark Hoffmann. I am the Small Fruits Extension Specialist at NC State University. And today we will talk about fertility, the basics of strawberry fertility for annual hill spring strawberry plasticulture production. And I want to go with you over a couple of things. First, about the typical fertilizer cycle for strawberries. If you're a beginner or a new grower, that is important to know. There are two parts to this. And then we're going to go over those two parts. The first part is the pre-plant part, and the second part is bloom and harvest, which we is now in like about a month from now. So the fertilizer cycle looks like this. We have two types of fertilizer application. The first is what we call the pre-plant fertilizer application. That usually happens before planting. It depends a little bit on the region, usually September or early October. And it happens before bed shaping, before fumigation, before plastic laying, about a day or two before that. It's a one-time application of granular fertilizer. And then we have our spring fertigation system, which is usually starts around March and then goes until the end of the season. It starts with the first bloom and it ends at the end of season. And that is a frequent fertilizer application through drip tape. It's liquid fertilizer. And that's usually done weekly, sometimes monthly, mostly weekly, sometimes more than 2 to 3 times per week. And we go over both systems here. So for the pre-plant phase, a little bit important knowledge just as a background. Strawberries do really prefer sandy loam or sandy soil with like a lot of airflow. They don't like standing water. That's why clay loam is usually that's why clay and rocks are not very preferred by strawberries. You can't grow them in there. It's going to be a little bit harder also to lay the bed. And you often have to pre-bed to get it to that height. So those are two really important points. Another important point which you should do before you apply fertilizer is a pre-plant about 4 months before planting. So also about 3.5 months or 4 months before you apply fertilizer, 3 months before you apply fertilizer, is to take soil samples in a zigzag cheam, as you can see here, depending on what type of soil type you have, can be very different, in a depth of 8 inches, and check, especially for your pH, and apply lime to your soil so that your pH is around 6 to 6.5. Also important parameters here are potassium and phosphorus content of your soil that will determine a little bit how much fertilizer you're going to apply later. So if it comes down to the fertilizer as a rule of thumb, you want to apply about half the nitrogen which is needed for a spring production system in plasticulture. That depends a little bit on the cultivar, but usually for a Chandler, we're looking at 120 pounds of nitrogen per acre per year, so for one season, and we apply about 60 of that in the beginning. We also, if you are on a phosphorus low soil, you want to apply about 120 pounds of acre of phosphorus. That is the whole amount of phosphorus which we need, and then also 120 pounds of potassium. But again, according to your soil test recommendations, potassium and phosphorus amount could change. There is a very good source, and most of the graphs I show in this presentation are coming from this source. It's a 2015 strawberry fertility guide published by the North Carolina Department of Agriculture here in North Carolina. This is the link. We will provide that link as well to everybody. And as a PDF, it's free and it's definitely worth reading. We also apply boron, very rare on sandy soils. It really depends on your soil test. Boron is often supplied in the spring as a one-time application. And we often apply sulfur as a mix into our pre-plant fertilizer. And typical strawberry fertilizers for nitrogen as nitrogen source can be D-ammonium phosphate, ammonium sulfate, potassium nitrate. And also for phosphate and potassium sources, especially for potassium sources, often growers use polysulfate or KMAG is a fertilizer which can be mixed into your preplant fertilizer. Again, for sulfur, same potassium sulfate or gypsum, polysulfate or KMAG, again, are used by some growers as a substitute for, especially for potassium and sulfur sources. And again, boron is not very often supplied as a preplant fertilizer. You have to be careful because boron is also can be very toxic. If you have to apply boron, don't apply more than 1 pound per acre. The reality is that often people, especially small growers, use full spectrum fertilizers. That can be done. Some substitute those then with those sulfur and potassium sources. You have to be careful. You can get over the potassium you need, or over the sulfur you need. Common full spectrum fertilizers that are laid down as a preplant are 10 10 10 10 20 10 or 6 6 18. Again, if you do have the capacity, you mix your own fertilizer. I would recommend to do that rather than relying on a full spectrum fertilizer. If we go into the bloom and harvest, so what's basically happening now, one extremely important tool for everybody is frequent tissue sampling. You're going to have to know what the nutritional status of your strawberry plant is. You do that by sampling detached petioles and a most recent mature trifoliate, and detach those and send them separate to a lab. In our case, in North Carolina, it's the North Carolina Department of Agriculture laboratory. You do that every 2 to 3 weeks so that you have a history of what's going on in your strawberry field. And that way you can stay on top of the fertigation, which is liquid fertilizer. Usually you want to sample those before noon to stay consistent also without cloud cover. So this is a table which comes out of that source which I cited earlier. And you can see here two growth stages on the left. That's a B stands for bloom and F stands for flowering. And you see also the weeks which we have during a normal season and the petiole nitrogen target range, which you want to support. So often growers, you often supply between 5.25 to 7 pounds of nitrogen per acre per week. But you're going to have to be careful not to provide too much nitrogen. Cultivars can get very bushy and can also get very soft fruit if you supply too much nitrogen. And there is a big difference between how much nitrogen cultivars need, especially ever-bearing cultivars like Albion will need quite a bit of more nitrogen than, let's say, Camarosa will need. And you cannot have both of them on the same fertigation regime. If you grow both cultivars, they will need to have two different fertigation regimes, for example. So this is all tailored to short day cultivars like Chanter or Camarosa. Also here you see nutrition recommendations based on the leaf blade interpretations. You see here the recommended sufficiency ranges for all the important nutrients, and again the recommendations of what to supply if you're outside of this sufficiency range. Nitrogen is basically the most important thing you supply over the season. We usually look at 5.25, 5.75 pounds per acre per week through 7 pounds per acre per wheat. And we usually in North Carolina, we start begin to mid of March with fertilization. Really depends a lot on the weather. Once you start your fertilization and you see blooms, you kind of have committed. So even if there are frost or freeze events coming, you will have to basically cover your plants and hope that not the blooms are not going to be affected by the frost event if you start fertilization too early. So you really want to wait with that until you're clear and you know you're going to start picking. Recommended fertilizer resources are calcium nitrate, potassium nitrate, ammonium nitrate. Again, you can also supply sulfur through the liquid as liquid fertilizer as Epsom salt or potassium sulfate. And also potassium boron can be supplied usually as a one-time application also boron very low, 0.125 pounds per year. You really want to stay at that. And that is something which is very common in our area here. The reality, again, some people use full spectrum fertilizers. I do not recommend that. If you have the capacity to use a different fertilizer, I would recommend to use a different, and mix your own fertilizer. And now here, as a last thing, I want to just go quick about fertilizer calculations. This is a very easy example, but I hope it is very helpful. And our target is 7.5 pounds of nitrogen per acre per week. This is what we want to supply through the drip line. And we do have 50 pound bags of a full spectrum fertilizer, which is 10-20-10 as an example. This is our example. And so how do you know how many bags you need per week? So what you do in the first place, you take your weight of the bag and you multiply that with the percentage of nitrogen, which you want to have, which you have in the bag, which in this case is 10%. So the first number of those 10-20-10 stands for the percentage of nitrogen equivalent, which you find in the bag of fertilizer. So to know how much fertilizer is actually in the bag, you multiply 50 pounds with this equivalent, which is 0.1, and then you have 5 pounds of nitrogen per bag. So this is what you have in your 50 pound bags, 5 pounds of that is a nitrogen equivalent. Now you wanna know how many bags you need per acre per week. So you wanna have how many nitrogens you wanna apply. So you target 7.5 pounds, that's the second step. And you divide that by the amount of nitrogen which you have in your bag. In our case, it's 7.5 pounds divided by 5. So you need 1.5 bags per week to supply those 7.5 pounds of nitrogen per acre per week. And with that, I hope you enjoyed this. I'm happy to take some questions later. And I hope you enjoy the next speaker. Thank you very much.